Your name is the highest. Your name is the greatest. Your name stands above them all.
Hi, everyone. This is day 3 of Jesus's saving strength. What I'm sharing with you is accounts from the Bible as Jesus walked from city to city, how he touched, how he healed, how he saved, and how he delivered those who were oppressed by the kingdom of darkness, those who were oppressed by fear, those who were oppressed by the things that we glorify and we celebrate this time of year. I want to show you the saving power and the strength of our Lord Jesus Christ to dominate or triumph over all of these things. So day by day, for 7 days in total, I am sharing one account from the Bible. One account from the Bible a day. And they're short videos. So please, if you know someone who would be blessed by these teachings, please feel free to share. My purpose is to spread the word of the Lord. And anybody who may be walking in fear or torment or having issues, especially this time of year, to show them that the word of the Lord is true. Every word, every account in the Bible, it is true. We live and we walk in a spiritual battle day to day. However, we don't have to live under that oppression, under that hand of oppression, because the Lord God Almighty sent his only Son, Jesus Christ, that whomever believes in him should be saved, and we should be healed and delivered. We should walk in complete wholeness. That is what Jesus died for, that we walk in an abundant life. So without further ado, let me pray, and then I'll read to you the account from the Bible for today. So Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for your people. I thank you, Father, for whomever you have appointed and predestined to connect with this video and to listen and hear your word. I pray, Father, that your word go forth with power, that the light of your word, that the entrance of your word gives light. Let it give light unto the people that are listening and watching now. In the name of Jesus, let truth be made known. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. So let's read. For those of you following along, I'm reading from John chapter 4, verse 46. Verse 46. John chapter 4, verse 46. So Jesus came again to Cana of Galilee, where he had turned the water into wine, and there was a certain royal official, so a certain man, whose son was laying ill in Capernaum. Having heard that Jesus had come back from Judea into Galilee, so Jesus came back from a different place to a different place, just to make it simple, he went away and met Jesus, and he began to beg him to come down and cure his son. For he was lying at the point of death. So the son was lying at the point of death, and he was begging him, come down and cure my son. Come to my son and cure him. Then Jesus said to him, unless you see signs and miracles happen, you people never will believe, trust, and have faith at all. The king's officer pleaded with him, sir, do come down at once before my little child is dead. Jesus answered him, go in peace, your son will live. And the man put his trust in what Jesus said and started home. Jesus answered him. He said, go in peace, your son will live. And what did the man do? It says, the man put his trust in what Jesus said, and he started home. He believed, he trusted in, he leaned on, he relied on what Jesus spoke. He believed it to be true, and so it was. So even as he was on the road, his servants met him and reported, saying, your son lives, your son lives, your son is alive. So as the man was returning home, his servants were running out to meet him and saying, he's alive, your son lives, he's well, your son lives. Then the father knew that it was at that very hour when Jesus had said to him, your son will live, that his son indeed lived. And he and his entire household believed. To believe means to adhere to, trust in, and rely on Jesus. The entire household believed because of this miracle. This is the second sign, wonder, work, miracle that Jesus performed after he had come out of Judea into Galilee. So what's interesting to me is they beg Jesus, you know, come and touch my son. Come and touch my son. And often that's what we think we have to bring, you know, bring our children that we want the Lord to touch, bring them for somebody to lay hands on them. But Jesus, what did he do? He spoke a word. Healing can come forth just from speaking a word. But also, you see that the father was kind of standing in the gap for the child. He was petitioning the Lord for healing. He was petitioning for the Lord, to the Lord, for healing for his son. And the Lord indeed heard his petition, answered him, and his son was healed. It's amazing. So just the power of the spoken word from Jesus Christ healed. Now, the other thing I wanted to mention to you is how this affected the man's entire household. The entire household was saved because of that miracle. The entire household was saved. So I want to encourage you, if there's another mother listening right now, even a father, whomever it is that believes in the Lord Jesus Christ, you're praying to God, you're praying, and you want the Lord to move upon your household, you want the Lord to move upon your children, the Lord will answer the prayers of the mother or the father. Keep praying. Don't lose hope. I want to encourage you not to lose hope. Jesus is alive. Our God is not dead. Jesus Christ, he did not die and stay in the grave such as other gods did. Jesus Christ died and he rose again. And when he died, he descended. Before he ascended, he descended. So he did something. What was he doing when he descended? Jesus has power. Jesus has power. I pray that you are encouraged by this word. I pray that it has ignited a little iota of faith in somebody that might have been losing faith or hope in Jesus Christ. His power is real. His power is real today. His power is real today in Jesus' name. Jesus saves, he heals, and he delivers. He has power. Do not give up hope in Jesus' name. Thank you so much for joining. I will see you for day 4.